It got off to a shaky start.
Tell us why you believe the United States might strike Russia.
I didn't say that.
Are we having a talk show or a serious conversation?
And then it got dangerously boring as Putin offered a Russian history lesson.
If you don't mind, I will take only 30 seconds to give you a short historical background.
Please.
25 minutes later.
In 882, Rurik's successor, Prince Oleg.
You can just feel Tucker's mind starting to wander. Anyway, Putin harked back to being dissed by the US.
After 1991, when Russia expected that it would be welcomed into the brotherly family of civilized nations, nothing like this happened. You tricked us. I'm talking about the United States.
And he explained how then US President Clinton said, to them joining NATO.
I asked him, Bill, do you think if Russia asked to join NATO, do you think it would happen? He said, no, it's not possible now.
You're clearly bitter about it.
Oh, and also mentioned how his idea for a joint missile defense system was shot down.
I suggested working together, Russia, the United States, and Europe. In the end, they just told us to get lost.
Putin gave no indication his invasion of Ukraine would cease.
Our goal is to stop this war.
Do you think you've stopped it now?
No, we haven't achieved our aims yet, because one of them is denazification.
He also savagely nicked the White House.
When was the last time you spoke to Joe Biden?
I cannot remember when I talked to him.
You don't remember?
Why would I call him? What should I talk to him about? You're going to deliver such and such weapons to Ukraine? Oh, I'm afraid, please don't.
Tucker even asked him about AI for some reason.
So when does the AI empire start?
Yeah, it was awkward.
Shall we end here, or is there anything else?
Well, joining us now is the host of the ABC's Russia, If You're Listening podcast, Matt Bevin. Matt, were you impressed at all by this interview?
Look, not hugely. It was not hugely surprising. It was 2 hours long. It was a bit of a slog. My advice is definitely listen to it at 1.5 speed if you can. Literally for the first 50 minutes of the interview, Putin is doing a long monologue about the last 1,000 years of Russian history. And Tucker Carlson is occasionally asking him, yes, but why is any of this relevant? And he kind of goes, can I finish the answer, the 45-minute answer to the first question, please? And Carlson's like, oh, okay, go ahead. All right, good. Now, in 1642, it was a nightmare.
Matt, it seems to me that it's obvious why Tucker Carlson would do this. It's a Western exclusive. But why would Vladimir Putin agree to do this interview?
He likes to do long, 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 uninterrupted, unedited interviews. So that's his idea. I'm going to give a 2-hour monologue on Russian history, and everyone in America will finally understand why Ukraine needs to be invaded and why they should stop helping the Ukrainian army. I very much doubt that many Americans are going to get through the full 2 hours, though. I barely did.
And why do you think he chose to do the interview with Tucker Carlson?
Tucker Carlson is, while he was on Fox News and then since he was fired from Fox News and now he does his show on Twitter, he has for a very long time been fairly anti-support for Ukraine. Tucker Carlson is strongly of the opinion that the problem with the world is there is a cabal of elite shadowy figures controlling everything. And they're the cause of all the world's ills. And the reason this war happened is because NATO was expanding into the West. And all the way through the interview, Tucker Carlson is trying over and over again to get Putin to say that. Please, he's going, and would you say that it's because of NATO expansion? Would you say it's because of Western elites? And Putin's going, shush. In 1912, I want to say about this, that, and the other, and these, and it's just, it's painful to see Carlson trying to help Putin through this interview and Putin giving him nothing and, in fact, insulting Tucker Carlson once or twice.
So this is really interesting and it's big news today. I'm interested in whether this interview actually matters, though, in any kind of significant way beyond now.
There's nothing. It's difficult to pull anything newsworthy out of the interview. And in terms of the effect that it's going to have on Americans' view of the war, I just don't think many people are going to be able to slog their way through the 45-minute rant.
Matt, besides, like, best brunch spots in Russia, what questions should Carlson have asked?
Throughout the interview, it's really unclear what Putin's willing to give up to end this war. And Tucker Carlson didn't really ask him any questions about that. But I guess, you know, there were many questions Tucker Carlson didn't ask, but there were many questions that Tucker Carlson did ask and Putin didn't answer. So he probably wouldn't have answered any of the better questions that Tucker Carlson could have asked if he had wanted to.
Matt, thank you very much for your time.
More than welcome.